Now, when we talk about MVC application, your program can flow from controller to a view, it can flow from controller to controller, or probably it can flow from view to a controller. So there are different combinations possible, you know, as we move or navigate between each one of these entities. Now, as we navigate between these entities, we would like to persist data between each of these entities. Now, if you remember right, in one of our previous videos, we have already discussed how to pass data from controller to view, that is by using viewdata. So if you remember, just I will flip back to the index. So you can see above, you know, we have this MVC ASP.NET Q&A series. And if you remember right, in the second video in lab 2, we had discussed, you know, how we can pass data from controller to views by using viewdata. So what I'll do is, let me quickly go back and revise what we did in lab 2. And then we will look into various other options which are available to persist data between each one of these entities. Now, before I demonstrate view data, let me talk about four different ways by which you can go and persist data between each one of these entities. So the first one is view data, which we are going to demonstrate now. Second one is view bag. Third one is temp data, and the last one is session variables. So let's first start with demonstrating view data, and then we will look into view bag, then temp data, and finally session variables. So what I'll do is, let me go ahead and add a very simple controller here. You can see that I have created a very simple project here called as view data temp data. So let me just go ahead and add a very simple controller here first, and we'll name this controller as sample controller or my sample controller. Okay. And I'll just say add. Now from this my sample controller, let's go ahead and invoke a view called as sample view. Okay. So what we'll do is, let's first go and demonstrate how to pass data from controller to views. Now, in order to pass data from controller to views, we can use something called as view data. So what I'll do is, I'll go in this controller, I'll create a view data here. I'll create a view data by name. Now, in order to create view data, you have to type view data and give some name to it. So you can see that on the screen, I'm going to say here view data, let's say current date and time, current date and time. Okay, big name. And we'll go and store the current date and time in this view data called as current date and time. Right now we want to display this current date and time in some view called as sample view. So let me just go ahead and add a sample view here. I'm going to go and add a view called as sample view. Let's go ahead and use ASPX, because I'm personally comfortable currently with ASPX view engine, and we'll say add. Now here's a view called as sample view. Now this view data which we have set over here, right, we want to go and display it on the view, right? So I'm going to go and do a control C here, and let's go back to sampleview.aspx, and over here I'll say percentage equal to, and display me the view data, right? So now if I go and invoke this controller here called as my sample, and if I go and invoke the action sample view, you know, it will actually go and persist this current date and time, and it will go and display this current date and time on this page here. So let me quickly go and build this, and let me do a control F5. So build succeeded, that is good. So let me do a control F5 here. So there our application is running, but we need to go and invoke the appropriate controller and action. So our controller name is my sample and our action is sample view. So we need to type here my sample and sample view. So if I press enter over here, I should see the current date and time. Okay, still running. There it is. So you can see now, you know, the current date and time is seen on the view. If I refresh it, I see the recent time. Okay, so that means, you know, whatever data we are setting here in this view data, it is actually getting displayed onto this view here. And what I can quickly do is, you know, just to show you in a better way, I'll just go and run this project in a debug mode. Must be that's a more better way of showing how the data is passed by using viewdata. So I'm going to go and start this whole thing in a debug mode just to show you step by step how the data flows using viewdata. So now the application is running in a debug mode. So we'll say here my sample, and we'll press sample view action. The time I do that, you know, it goes to the debug mode here. You can see now the application is now debugging. So what happens is the data gets set here. So we can see now this view data has the current date and time, right? And if I do a F11, if I go to the view here now very quickly, so there I am now inside the view. Now you can see this view data here very quickly. The data is now transferred. Let me just do a quick watch here. So if you see this output here, quick watch, you can see the current date and time, right? So view data helps you to pass data from controller to the view. Now there is one more way by which you can go and pass data from controller to views, and that is by using something called as Viewbag. Now Viewbag is nothing but it is collection of view data. It simplifies the syntaxes of view data. If you remember right, in the previous example, when we were writing view data, we were putting you know, a square bracket, then a double quotes, you know, a lot of things, right? So Viewbag, you know, helps you to simplify syntaxes of view data, first thing. And Viewbag uses the dynamic keyword of .NET. So in case you are not aware of dynamic keyword, I would suggest you to go and see the .NET fundamental section where we have talked about the dynamic keyword. So Viewbag simplifies the syntaxes of view data. Viewbag is a collection of view data. Now let's go ahead and see a simple example of a Viewbag. So we'll take the same example which we were discussing previously. So if you want to go and change this code to Viewbag, the way it works is, now if you see now, right, I need to go and stop this debug mode. Now if you see the current syntax, right, it is a bit cryptic, right? You have to say view data, then a square bracket, then double quotes and a lot of things, right? But if you try to translate this view data into Viewbag syntax, it will be something like this. You'll say here Viewbag dot, and then you can say current date and time and whatever value you want to set. So date time dot now. That's it. Now you can see that how our syntax has simplified, right? I'm not using those square brackets and double quotes and those kind of syntax, right? And if I want to access this view bag in the view, again it's pretty easy. So here I can just go and type this control V. That's it. I'll just do a build here. And let me just go and run this project in a debug mode. F5. So my sample and sample view. So there it goes. Now you can see that how our variable of view bag is getting set here. So you can see now the view bag variable. If I do a quick watch here, quick watch, and I can see the current date and time set. Now if I do F11, and now I go to the view. So there I'm moving to the view, and here I should get the value from the view bag. So if I do a quick watch here, you can see the value over here, and I do a F5, and I can see the current date and time displayed by using view bag. So Viewbag is nothing but it encapsulates view data. It simplifies your syntaxes. You think in terms of properties, you know, rather than writing those square brackets and double quotes and cryptic syntaxes. And Viewbag uses the dynamic keyword of .NET. Okay, so these are the two ways by which you can go and pass data from controller to views. So now this is good. So if you want to move from controller to view, or if you want to process data from controller to view, we will either use Viewdata or Viewbag. But now let's say that we want to move from one action to other action. So for example, now you can see that we have an action here called a sample view, and let's say that we want to move, or we want to process data, you know, when we move from one action to other action. So for example, let me just go and create one more action here called as sample view one, let's say. Okay, and this sample view one, actually what it does is it actually returns the sample view. let's say returns sample view, okay? And this sample view action actually redirects to the sample view one. So in order to redirect from one action to other action, we can use something called as redirect to action. So I can say here redirect to action sample view one. So you can see over here that somebody comes and hits this action here called a sample view, and this action actually redirects to other action called as sample view one. Okay, so now if I set any data over here, now you can see that we are setting a data here, right? We are setting date time now into this view bag. You know, can I go and access this view bag over here? Let's try to see that. So what I'll do is, you can see that I am already setting this data over here. I'll just try to get this data into a string variable, right? So I'll just say here view bag dot current date time. So let's try to check, you know, if this data which is set here, can we access that data into this action over here, right? So let me just go and build this, and let me do a F5 so that we can see the whole thing in a debug mode. So there our application is running. So we'll say here slash sample view. So we are invoking sample view, we are setting this data over here, and now we are redirecting. So I'm going to go and put a breakpoint here. So now it redirects here, you can see. Now if you see this view bag here, right, let me just go and do a quick watch. You can see the view bag is null. You can see over here the view bag is null. In other words, view bag and view data do not persist data when you move from one action to other action. For that we have to use something called as temp data. And let me go and change this to temp data. So I'll say here temp data current date and time, and then here again temp data, and we need to just do a typecast here to string. Okay, so temp data will help you to persist data, you know, or help you to persist your variables, you know, when you move from one action to other action. Now if I go and do a F5 here, so let me do this. I'm running in a debug mode slash my sample view. So that you can see the sample view has got invoked. So you can see over here this temp data is now set to current date and time. Good. Now if you see over here, now I am into this action, other action here, right? Sample view one. So now if I do a quick watch here, you can see the data has persisted. So if I do F5 again, in the string variable I am getting the current date and time which was set over here in the sample view. So in short, if you want to persist data from action to action, you will use temp data. If you want to persist data from controller to view, you will use view bag or view data. Now the way view data and view bag do not help you to persist information when you move from one action to other action, in the same way, when you are moving from action to a view, temp data will not help you to persist information. Temp data is only meant when you move from one action to other action. So let me just go and put a big summary picture over here, you know, where view data, temp data and view bag fits in. So if you are moving from controller to view, use view data or view bag. View bag is a collection of view data. If you are moving from controller to controller, use temp data. In case you want to persist information from view to controller, you know, you can either use hidden field, your text boxes, via query strings, and you can use the HTTP post and HTTP get. Now this part, you know, that is persisting data from view to controller, we have already discussed in the previous part of the videos, where we have seen a lot of examples, you know, how to go and post data from text boxes to controllers, right? So this is the big picture of where temp data, view bag fits in. Now sometimes, you know, you'd like to just go and persist information, you know, throughout the time the end user is on his browser. In other words, you know, when you move from controller to view, or from view to controller, or from controller to controller, wherever, right, you want to persist information. At that time you can use something called as session variables. Now the session variables are nothing but, you know, they are derived from ASP.NET framework. So they are same as ASP.NET framework. Okay. So session variables, you know, will persist, you know, either you move from controller to controller, either you move from controller to view, or either you move from view to controller. They will persist, you know, until the user session is open. So let me just go and show you an example of session variables. So I can just go and change it to session here. Right. So I'm using now session variables. Now from this action, let me just go and redirect over here. You say your session. So what will happen is now this session variable will be accessed over here as well. Okay. And what I'll do is I'll go and set some new value to the session variable over here. Control C, Control V, right? And let me put a new date and time dot now. And let me try to display this session variable inside this view over here, right? Now, the way I'm doing here is I'm moving from action to action, that is from sample view to sample view one. And I'm moving from action to a view, that is from sample view one to this sample view.aspx. But you will see that this session variable is persisted, you know, you move from any entity to any entity. So if I go and run this in a debug mode now, just to quickly see how session variables work. So slash sample view. So the first thing in sample view, I'm setting the value. So if you see now, the current date and time which has been set is 2:59:20. Okay. Now if I go here, you can see that it is accessed here 2:59:20. Great. Now we go and set a new value here. Okay. In the sample view one, to see that, you know, this value is persisted in the view or not. So now this is time tested. This is tested, right? That when you move from one action to other action, the session variable persisted, right? Now let me go and set some new value here. So now the new value which is set here very quickly, it is 2:59:53. Okay. Now let me do a F11 here. And now the same value I should be able to see in the view. So now I'm going in the view, and here also I should see quick watch, and you can see 2:59:53. So session variables, you know, you move either from controller to controller, or you move from action to action, or you move from action to a view, right? You know, the data will be maintained. So again, let me just show you that big picture, what I was talking about, so that we can clearly get the differences between all these persisting mechanisms. So let's go and summarize everything what we have learned. So the first thing is, if you want to go and persist information throughout your MVC cycle, or throughout, you know, until the user has kept his browser open, you can use session variables. If you want to store information while you're moving from action to action, you can use temp data. If you want to maintain your information when you move from controller to a view, you can use viewdata or viewbag. Viewbag is a collection of view data. Viewbag derives from the dynamic keyword. And if you want to maintain your data or persist your information when you move from view to controller, you can use HTTP POST, GET, query string, hidden fields, request.form, etc. So I hope that you enjoyed this video. In this video, we were trying to understand what are the different persisting mechanisms in MVC, and we talked about temp data, view data, view bag, session variables, and I hope that you enjoyed this video. Thank you so much.